Hello everyone, and welcome to a look back at Norfolk and Western excursion engines. To start off, I'd like to apologize for the long gap between videos. My hard drive recently failed abruptly, but thanks to help from my family, I was able to get it sorted. If you want to see updates for future videos, please be sure to check out my community tab, where I occasionally post updates. Before we get started, I'd like to announce that the next video in this series is going to be another catch-up video, similar to this one here. If there's any engines from any video in the Look Back At series that I've missed, please leave them in the replies to my pinned comment. With that being said, let's get started. Our first engine is number 578. This locomotive is a Class E2A Pacific built by Alco in 1910, making it one of, if not the only engine in this video, to not be built by the NNW's Roanoke shops. The engine came equipped with 70-inch drivers, Baker valve gear, a maximum boiler pressure of 200 psi, and a tractive effort of roughly 34,500 pounds. In total, the engine and tender weigh a combined 468,950 pounds. Throughout its early career in revenue service, the 578 was assigned to high-end passenger trains along the NNW system, mostly running trains out of Columbus, Ohio. By the mid-1940s, 578, along with the NNW's other 462s, were bumped down to local passenger trains as more powerful mountain and northern-type engines were added to the NNW roster. By 1958, the 578 had been demoted to maintenance train service in Virginia and West Virginia, and would be retired later that year. In 1959, 1 year after its retirement, the 578 will be donated to the Ohio Railway Museum in Worthington, Ohio. With the engine still being in good mechanical condition, the museum quickly put the engine to work, hauling tourists around the museum, making it the first NNW steam locomotive to operate in the preservation era. The 578 would continue to haul passengers for the museum until 1966, when the engine's flue time expired. 4 years later, the 578 would once again return to operation, continuing to haul trains for the museum. Unfortunately, not long into her second round of operation at ORM, it was discovered that the 578 had some serious mechanical problems and was pulled from service. After determining that the issues were too expensive for the museum to repair, the 578 was placed on static display. As of today, the 578 continues to remain on display outdoors at the Ohio Railway Museum. Next up is NNW number 2174. 2174 is a 2882 Y6B built by the NNW's own shops in Roanoke, Virginia in the late 1940s. The Y6Bs were considered to be some of the most powerful steam locomotives to operate in the eastern United States. The Y6Bs were built with 58-inch drivers, Baker valve gear, a max boiler pressure of 300 psi, and a whopping tractive effort of 125,000 pounds. The engine and tender combined to weigh a total weight of 990,000 pounds. The 2174, along with the rest of its sisters, was used in heavy coal drags throughout the states of Virginia and West Virginia. With the NNW being a coal-carrying road, it was one of the last railroads to fully dieselize, holding on to steam much longer than any other Class 1. Realizing that the end of steam would eventually encroach on the NNW, the Roanoke chapter of the National Railway Historical Society sponsored a farewell to steam excursion. The 2174 was selected to be on the head end of this excursion, which occurred on July 11, 1959. Following the excursion, the locomotive would continue to see use in revenue service until April of 1960, when the last handful of steam left on the NNW had their fires dropped, closing out the final chapter of revenue mainline steam in the United States. Following her retirement, the 2174, along with two other sister engines, were sold to a scrap company in Roanoke, Virginia. There, the three locomotives sat for a number of years. After one of the other engines, along with a tender, were scrapped in 1967, the remaining engines were moved near NNW's Roanoke shop complex in 1958. The company even offered to donate the engines to the city of Roanoke and have them displayed at the nearby Virginia Museum of Transportation. However, the city had no interest in the engines. The 2174 was then moved back to the scrapyard in 1970. At the time, the Roanoke chapter of the NRHS was making a desperate bid to acquire the last remaining Y6Bs. The scrap company told the NRHS that the engines were valued at $50,000, and so they spent most of the early 70s raising money to try and buy them. Unfortunately, in 1975, the scrap company was taken over by a new set of owners from the UK. Having zero interest in preserving the engines, the 2174 and her sister 2143 were scrapped later that year. At the time, it was one of the biggest losses of the preservation era, not being topped until the unfortunate loss of Grand Trunk Western's 5629 in 1987. Our next engine is locomotive number 475. The 475 was built by the Baldwin Locomotive Works in June of 1906, and is an M-Class 480 Mastodon. The engine came equipped with 56-inch drivers, Stevenson valve gear, which was later swapped out for Baker valve gear, a maximum boiler pressure of 200 psi, and a tractive effort of roughly 40,000 pounds. The engine and tender combined to weigh a total of 373,700 pounds. 480s were relatively uncommon in the United States, with the majority of them being built at the turn of the 20th century by only a handful of Class 1 railroads. By the time the 20s and 30s rolled around, larger wheel arrangements had already come onto the scene, rendering most 480s irrelevant. The NNW was one of the few railroads that ordered the 480s en masse and stuck with them until the end of the steam era. In revenue service, the 475 was assigned to typical mainline freight duties, hauling mostly local coal drags across the system. As time went on and more powerful engines joined the NNW roster, the 475 and her sisters were moved to branch line duties, eventually being retired in 1956. Shortly following its retirement, the 475 underwent a complete cosmetic overhaul, being given a protruding pilot and a diamond smokestack as part of a brief stint hauling the Salem Shifter, a local passenger train that ran in and around Roanoke at the time. 475 frequently headed up the train as an exhibition locomotive between 1957 and 58. In 1959, the locomotive was pulled from the NNW roster for good and placed on display in Roanoke, where it would remain for the next 2 years. In 1962, the 475 was moved from its display site and sold to a Roanoke-based scrap company. The engine would sit in the scrapyard for another year before being purchased by William Armagost. He would hold onto the engine for another 17 years before selling the engine once again to H.S. Kuiper in 1980. In turn, Kuiper gave the engine to the Pella Historical Society, who elected to store the engine at the Illinois Railway Museum in Union, Illinois. In 1982, the 475 would once again come under new ownership, being purchased by a group of rail fans who would then donate the engine to the Boone and Scenic Valley Railroad, where it would be placed on display in 1986. Much like your tenures with previous owners, the 475 would not remain there for very long. In 1991, the 475 would be bought by the Strasburg Railroad in Strasburg, Pennsylvania, and moved to their shop complex for restoration. After 2 years of hard work, the 475 would triumphantly return to operation in 1993. During the 475's time on the Strasburg Railroad, the engine had undergone a number of minor alterations in her appearance over the years. Throughout the 90s and into the mid-2000s, the 475 could most commonly be seen with a red centered number plate and a high, shelf-mounted headlight, with the Strasburg lettering on the tender. In 1999, the engine was temporarily relettered for the fictional Indian Valley Railroad as part of her role in the live-action segments of the film Thomas and the Magic Railroad. As the 2010s rolled around, the red number plate was swapped out for a more prototypical black and yellow number plate, and could be found wearing NNW lettering on her tender from time to time. Her biggest visual alteration came in late 2019. To commemorate the arrival of former running mate number 611, which we'll get to later, the 475 returned to its prototypical 1950s-era appearance, featuring a centered headlight with flying number boards. In addition, the engine was given an original NNW freight hooter, which it would continue wearing until October 2021, when it was swapped out with a Southern Pacific 6-chime. As of today, the 475 continues operating on the Strasburg Railroad, hauling tourists back and forth on the 4-mile line through Amish country. And now, we've come to easily one of the more popular engines to be featured in this video, Class A 2664 number 1218. 1218 was built by the NNW's Roanoke shops in June of 1943 to help meet wartime traffic demands. The engine comes equipped with 70-inch drivers, Baker valve gear, a maximum boiler pressure of 300 psi, a tractive effort of nearly 126,000 pounds, and a combined engine and tender weight of 951,600 pounds. Throughout its stint in revenue service, the 1218 was used for a wide variety of freight duties along the Scioto Division. It could just as easily handle a fast merchandise freight across the farmlands of Ohio as it could a heavy coal drag through the Blue Ridge Mountains in West Virginia. As the steam era came to a close on the NNW, the 1218 was moved back to Roanoke for use on the Norfolk Division. The engine would be retired in 1959 and moved to Charleston, West Virginia for use as a stationary boiler on the property of the Union Carbide Company. 6 years later, the engine would be purchased by F. Nelson Blount and moved to a Steamtown USA collection in Bellows Falls, Vermont. Sadly, Blount would be killed in a plane crash in 1967. Shortly thereafter, the engine was moved back to the NNW's Roanoke shops and was given a full cosmetic restoration by NNW crews. Following the completion of the cosmetic restoration in 1971, the 1218 was moved to the Roanoke Transportation Museum, where it will be placed on display. Jumping ahead 13 years later, the Norfolk Southern Railroad, formed via a merger of the NNW and Southern Railway, was looking for new motive power to head up trains for its famous steam excursion program, as its current fleet of steamers were unable to meet the ever-growing demands and longer trains, to the point where hundreds and possibly thousands of people were being often turned away from buying tickets. To alleviate this, NS selected the 1218 as their prime candidate for restoration. These intentions were made public following the conclusion of the 1984 operating season. In May of 1985, the 1218 was moved from Roanoke to the Norfolk Southern Steam Shops in Irondale, Alabama, for restoration. The restoration would be completed in January 1987, and the engine was immediately pressed into service. 1218 quickly proved to be a favorite among rail fans, drawing hundreds of people trackside wherever she went. Over the years, 1218 was used on a number of commemorative excursions and NRHS conventions, in addition to the regular excursions. Many of these special trips entailed doubleheaders with the likes of Nickel Plate Road 587, visits to St. Louis, Missouri and Huntington, West Virginia, and side-by-side photo run-bys featuring running mate 611. Between 1987 and 1991, the 1218 would rack up thousands of miles for NS. Unfortunately, it wasn't meant to last. In 1992, the 1218 would go down for heavy repairs and was expected to return to operation for the 1996 operating season. However, in 1994, the Norfolk Southern Steam Program was brought to an end due to what NS cited as rising insurance costs. Because of the unexpected end to the program, the 1218 was still in pieces, scattered across the Irondale shops. Crews quickly scrambled to reassemble what they could of the 1218, and the engine was moved back to Roanoke in 1996. In 2001, it was donated to the now rebranded Virginia Museum of Transportation, where it was once again placed on display in 2003. As of today, the 1218 continues to remain on display in Roanoke. The possibility of restoring the engine to service has been brought up time and time again, but the general consensus is that the engine has far too many missing parts as a result of the haphazard reassembly, and unfortunately, that's where the 1218 story comes to an end. Finally, our last engine is the Spirit of Roanoke herself, number 611. 611 is a streamlined Class J 484 built in the Roanoke shop complex in May of 1950. The engine is equipped with 70-inch drivers, Baker valve gear, a maximum boiler pressure of 275 psi, a tractive effort of roughly 78,000 pounds, and a total weight of 872,600 pounds. In revenue service, the 611, along with her 13 other sister engines, were assigned to NNW's highest priority passenger trains such as the Powhatan Narrow and the Pocahontas. In January of 1956, the engine was involved in a serious accident. After taking a corner at excessive speeds, the 611 jumped the tracks and slid down an embankment, killing the engineer. The engine was repaired and returned to service shortly thereafter. By the end of the decade, dieselization was beginning to catch up with the NNW. The J's were bumped from passenger service and replaced by shiny new GP9s from EMD. Prior to its retirement, the 611 was used to haul a pair of farewell to steam fan trips out of Petersburg and Roanoke in October of 1958. Just a few days later, the 611 was retired from revenue service. Despite its days in revenue service being over, the engine was kept by the NNW and used as a steam generator for the Roanoke shops until 1962, when its flue time expired. Fearing the engine would be scrapped, W. Graham Clater, a rail fan and attorney for the Southern Railway, convinced the NNW to preserve the 611 on account of its excellent mechanical condition. Following this, the 611 would be donated to the Roanoke Transportation Museum. Clater would go on to be an incredibly influential figure in the creation and management of the Southern Railway's highly successful steam excursion program, as well as becoming president of the Southern Railway. In 1982, the NNW would merge with the Southern to form Norfolk Southern. With it came a bigger and better steam program. In 1981, Robert Clater, Graham's brother and CEO of NNW and NS during their merger process, announced the railroad's intentions to include 611 as part of the excursion program. The engine was removed from its display site in Wasena Park later that year and transported to the Irondale shops for restoration. After several months of work, the 611 would steam again in July of 1982, ready to pull excursions. After a series of test runs throughout the month of August, the engine made its way to Roanoke for its grand return and would pull its first excursion, an NRHS special, on Labor Day weekend. Throughout the 1980s, the 611 would be used on a number of excursions across the NS system and quickly became a favorite among rail fans. Some of its more notable outings include appearances at NRHS conventions and doubleheaders or even tripleheaders with other notable steam stars. In 1984, the 611 would doublehead with Nickel Plate 765 for an excursion across X Nickel Plate Road trackage. In 1987, the 611, along with the aforementioned 1218, would team up for a special race from Roanoke to Radford, Virginia. the 611 Haldeman Excursion consists, while the 1218 followed on a parallel track with a string of empty hoppers. Tickets were also sold for the cabs of each locomotive, and the two engines would frequently back off to let the other pass. In 1989, the 611 and 1218 would partake in a triple header with nickel plate 587 from Cleveland, Ohio to Roanoke. That same year, the 611 would haul a recreated Powhatan Arrow from Roanoke to Lynchburg. In 1991, the 611 and 1218 would partake in yet another triple header, this time with Southern 4501 to commemorate the 25th anniversary of the steam program. Despite its immense popularity, things weren't all sunshine and rainbows for the 611 and the steam program. In 1986, while on the head end of an employee appreciation special, the 611's train derailed in the Great Dismal Swamp near Suffolk, Virginia. The derailment injured roughly 100 passengers, but thankfully there were no deaths. The cause of the accident was attributed to poor track maintenance. The 611 did not sustain any damage in the accident, as a derailment occurred several cars behind it. In the aftermath of the incident, NS placed a 40-mile-per-hour speed restriction on all future excursions and ceased usage of the Pullman heavyweights in its passenger fleet. The 611 would continue pulling excursions, but it wouldn't be the end of its problems. In late September of 1994, another accident severely damaged a number of passenger cars used in the excursion program, causing a shortage. This, along with the passing of the Clater brothers and the aforementioned rising insurance costs, would be the final nail in the coffin for the NS steam program. Shortly thereafter, NS announced it would be ending the steam program after 1994. The 611 would make her final excursion on December 3rd from Birmingham, Alabama to Chattanooga, Tennessee. Later that week, it would deadhead to Roanoke, where its fire would be dropped. After a brief period of storage in the Roanoke shops, the 611 would be donated to the city of Roanoke and placed on display in the Roanoke Transportation Museum, now rebranded as the Virginia Museum of Transportation. It would later be reunited with former running mate number 1218, and the two would sit cold for years to come. In the summer of 2010, 611's luck would begin to change. Under the leadership of then-CEO Wick Moorman, Norfolk Southern announced a revival of its steam program as 21st Century Steam. Right off the bat, 611 was a prime candidate for restoration. After a feasibility study was conducted by the Fire Up 611 Committee in 2013, NS determined that the locomotive was in excellent condition. In the spring of 2014, the 611 would be removed from its display site in Roanoke and moved to the North Carolina Transportation Museum's Spencer Shop Complex, where the restoration would be carried out. After a year-long restoration, the 611 triumphantly returned to operation in May 2015. After a grand homecoming to Roanoke, the 611 would embark on a number of trips across the NS system throughout the 2015 season. Despite the unfortunate conclusion of the program at the end of 2015, the 611 would still run a number of excursions over the NS main line as late as 2017. During this period, the 611 was given several nicknames such as the Spirit of Roanoke and the Queen of Steam. Unfortunately, the 611's return to the main line was brought to an end when Amtrak altered its policies regarding special excursions in April of 2018, effectively banning steam from operating under the Amtrak insurance banner. For most of 2018, the 611 was displayed at the North Carolina Transportation Museum, where it was occasionally steamed up for photographers' specials. In the spring of 2019, it was announced that the 611 would visit the Strasburg Railroad in Pennsylvania, where the engine would be reunited with former running mate number 475 mentioned earlier. From September to October, the two would embark on a number of excursions and photo specials along the 4-mile tourist line, and the event was a huge success for all involved. Following this, the 611 returned to Spencer, North Carolina once again, where it would spend the winter and ultimately all of 2020 with the onset of the COVID-19 pandemic. Thankfully, in the spring of 2021, it was announced that the 611 would once again be returning to Strasburg for a second round of excursions and photo specials. Despite some mechanical issues plaguing the 611 on her second stay, the event was once again a huge success. As of the time of recording, the 611 still remains the Strasburg complex.
Wait, where is the 611, actually? Actually, where is it? Did it go back to Spencer? I need to update my script.
As of the time of recording, the 611 currently remains at the Strasburg Railroad, undergoing routine maintenance in the Strasburg shop building, and will likely be returned to Spencer sometime this summer. And that concludes a look back at Norfolk and Western excursion engines. If you have any feedback or constructive criticisms, please leave them in the comments below, as well as any suggestions for future videos. As a reminder, the next video in this series will be another catch-up video. So, if there's any engines that I've missed across the whole series, please leave them in the replies to my pinned comment. Anyway, that's all for this video. Thanks for watching.